Hello friends, welcome to the video on triangles. In the previous video, we discussed about the congruence of triangles. Today, taking a step forward, we will discuss about the criterion for the congruence of triangles. The first criterion is side angle side. Friends, when two triangles are congruent, then there is one-to-one correspondence between their sides, angles, and vertices. But with the help of some sides and angles, can we prove two triangles to be congruent? In this video and in the upcoming video, we will see at least how many sides or angles must be equal for two triangles to be congruent. Friends, in triangle ABC and triangle PQR on the screen, both the sides AB and PQ are 6 cm and sides AC and PR are 7 cm. So will two triangles be congruent if the two sides of any two triangles are equal? Friends, will the third side also be equal? It may or may not be equal. That is, just two sides being equal is not a sufficient criterion for the congruence of triangles. So friends, can you tell under what circumstances can the third side of these triangles be equal? You can also pause the video for thinking. If the angle made by these two sides are equal, then will the third side also be equal? Due to the angles being same, the open portions of the other side of these sides will also be equal in length, and then we can say that these two triangles are congruent. That is, if a triangle's two sides and their included angle are equal to another triangle's two sides and their included angle, then the two triangles are congruent. This is called side angle side or SAS criterion. Can two triangles be congruent with lesser conditions? For example, one side and one angle of two triangles are equal. Here are some examples. Here, the triangles are not congruent by just having one equal side and one equal angle. Friends, apart from SAS, are two triangles congruent by the SSA rule, wherein two sides and one angle of a triangle which is not within these sides are equal to the sides and one angle of another triangle? By looking at the figure, we can tell that these two triangles are not congruent. Therefore, SSA cannot be accepted as the test for the congruence of triangles. Friends, the SAS congruence rule cannot be proved with the help of previously known results. Therefore, it is accepted as true in the form of an axiom. Why don't you do an activity? Cut two triangles from a paper in such a way that the two sides and the included angle of one triangle are equal to the two sides and the included angle of the other triangle. And then look at the two triangles by stacking them one on top of the other. Are they fitting exactly one on top of the other? Check. Friends, that's all in today's session. Today we studied the SAS criterion for the congruence of triangles. See you in the next video. Thank you. Hello friends, welcome to this video on triangles. In the previous video, we discussed about the side angle side or the SAS criterion for the congruence of triangles. Today, we will solve some questions related to the same. So let's start. In the given figure, side LM is equal to side LK and angle KLN is equal to angle MLN. So, prove that triangle KLN is congruent to triangle MLN. Let's see, if we look at the two triangles, then their one side and one angle is equal. Now, if you look at side LN, you will notice that it is that side in both the triangles that comes in order after one congruent side and angle. That is, when it is congruent, the side angle side congruence rule is formed. And since this side is the common side of the two triangles, it will be congruent. We can write it like this also. Therefore, triangle KLN is congruent to triangle MLN. And friends, while writing congruent triangles, write their names in the same order in which their sides and angles have one-to-one correspondence, or in the order in which they are congruent to each other. Let's move to the next question. In the given figure, line PR and line SQ are bisecting each other. So, prove that triangle PTQ is congruent to triangle RTS. Friends, if we look at triangle PTQ and triangle RTS, then since line PR and line SQ are bisecting each other, therefore sides TQ and TS are equal. Similarly, sides PT and TR are also equal. Now, if the angles between these sides, that is, angle PTQ and angle RTS are equal, then these triangles can be said to be congruent according to the SAS criterion. And since PR and SQ are lines and are intersecting each other at T, therefore, angle PTQ is equal to angle RTS as they are vertically opposite angles. Therefore, according to the SAS criterion, triangle PTQ is congruent to triangle RTS. Friends, you can see here that the names of the two triangles are in the same order as the congruence of their sides and angles. Let's take one more question. Look at the given figure and prove that triangle ABD and triangle CBD are congruent. Pause the video and try to solve this question yourself and finally see the solution. Friends, that's all in today's session. We solved some questions based on the SAS criterion of the congruence of triangles. See you in the next video with some more facts related to this topic. Thank you. Hello friends, welcome to this video on triangles. In the previous video, we discussed the SAS criterion for the congruence of triangles and we also solved some questions. Today, we will discuss some facts related to the same. So let's start. Look at the figure and choose the correct option of congruent triangles. Friends, according to the first option here, side WV is equal to side YX. Look in the figure and tell whether it is correct. Yes. Now, can you tell whether side VZ is equal to side XZ? No. Therefore, these triangles cannot be congruent. So, the first option is not correct. Now, let's move to the second option. Here, according to the name of the triangles, is side WV equal to side ZX? No. Therefore, this option is also incorrect. Now let's look at the last remaining option. According to the figure, side WV is equal to side XY. Angle WVZ is equal to angle XYZ and side ZV is equal to side ZY. So, according to the SAS congruence criterion, these triangles are congruent. So, the third option is the correct option. Friends, that's all in this session. Today we discussed some facts related to the SAS criterion. See you in the next video. Thank you.